Worst NHL contracts, Bobby Ryan. The Bobby Ryan contract is the worst contract in the entire NHL right now. It's not even close. The contract was a disaster right from the get-go because he was never worth this contract to begin with. Before the start of the 2014-15 season, Bobby Ryan was re-signed to a 7-year deal worth a total of $50 million. The contract would pay him $7.25 million per season over the course of 7 years and included a modified no-trade clause and no-movement clause. Since signing the contract, his point totals are as follows. In 2015-16, he got 56 points. In 2016-17, he got 25 points. In 2017-18, he got 33 points. And in 2018-19, he got 42 points. In the 2019-20 season, Ryan put up only 8 points in 24 games. To make matters worse, there are still 2 years left on this terrible deal. There are 47 players that are paid more than Bobby Ryan, yet 549 players have more points than Bobby Ryan. The Ottawa Senators don't have a lot of firepower in their lineup, but there are 15 players that have more points than Bobby Ryan this season. Yet Bobby Ryan gets paid $2.5 million more than the next highest paid player on the team. Even Milan Lucic, whose contract is considered terrible, played in 68 games this season and put up 20 points. At least Lucic is able to stay in the lineup and provide a physical presence in the lineup. He still has some value, although it's not the value he signed for. Bobby Ryan has no value because he can't stay healthy, he doesn't produce, and has a terrible contract. The only way the Senators will be able to trade him is if he remains on long-term IR longer than a season. But if he's forced to be on long-term IR, they might as well keep him because then they can use the cap space to sign other players. Bobby Ryan's best seasons were in Anaheim, when he played with Ryan Getzlaf and Corey Perry. He was always a bit overrated by the media and fans because I never saw him as an actual star player, but the beneficiary of playing with two world-class players. After acquiring Bobby Ryan in a trade from Anaheim, he had 23 goals in the 2013-14 campaign, which is solid production, but I don't think it warranted the contract he got. Ryan has averaged 32.8 points in the first 5 years of his contract, which means he gets paid around $220,000 for every point he gets. If Bobby Ryan had been able to stay healthy and put up maybe 50 to 60 points a season, the contract would still be tolerable, but he really has a production of a third liner. In fact, with the cap hit he has, the Senators could easily sign two really solid players or a star player rather than using that cap hit on Bobby Ryan. As bad as the Bobby Ryan contract is looking right now, it is understandable why he is signed to this contract. Because Ryan had 4 straight 30-goal seasons with Anaheim, and then with the Senators, he had a decent first year of the contract. But unfortunately for Bobby Ryan, he wasn't able to sustain his level of play. It is highly likely that Bobby Ryan gets bought out before 2021 because you do not want him taking up a spot in the protected players list for the expansion draft. The Bobby Ryan contract is now used as a precautionary tale of what happens when you give an overrated and injury-prone player a massive contract. On the next episode of Best NHL Contracts, I'll be talking about Sean Couturier.